Hi, I'm Exact Weather Meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on to your afternoon video cast. Let's take a look outside. This is our dome camera. And we are getting our fair share of cloud cover out there. There's some sunshine, but again, lots of cloud cover. And we're going to start working in these clouds here as we work in some daytime heating. And we are seeing some high overcast. Here's the reason why. Take a look at the satellite and radar imagery. Some showers and storms to our north. You get these high clouds, they blow off from these thunderstorms and are passing overhead right now. So that could maybe limit our afternoon heating, but still nonetheless, it is going to be a hot one. So we're going to continue with that summertime heat and humidity. It's all right here on your ExactCast headlines. Temperature still warming into the 90s in many spots. Rain going to be a little bit limited, going to keep it at about 20%. And now we have our next named storm, Tropical Storm Dorian, was born earlier in the day. Let me show you what's happening out there in the tropics. As you can see, the Gulf of Mexico actually looking pretty good. Clear skies, not a whole lot of thunderstorm activity, and Dorian is way out there. Take a look. This is the coast of Africa, so you can get an idea of just how far it's out there. Cape Verde Islands right now. Max sustained winds of 50 miles per hour, moving to the west-northwest at a pretty good clip, at about 21 miles per hour. Notice what happens as we move ahead in time. By tomorrow morning, looks like Dorian's going to gain a little strength with 60 mile per hour winds. And then watch what happens as we continue ahead in time. Dorian's going to be encountering some dry air, maybe a little wind shear, and some relatively cooler sea surface temperatures. So expecting Dorian to drop back down to 45 miles per hour. So nonetheless, we'll see a little bit of weakening. We'll have to keep an eye on the storm as it makes its way and gets just a bit closer as a weakened tropical storm. Now, satellite and radar imagery showing you this cluster of showers and storms that's pushing all the clouds our way. There is a cold front situated a little bit further to the north. Models want to push this through sometime Friday or Saturday. And for today, here's what we're dealing with. Maybe a little outflow boundary from that system that just passed. We're going to go with a rain chance of about 20%. This is 9 o'clock this evening. Still seeing this little boundary that's developing from some rains to our north. Is that going to happen? I'm going to say no. I'm going to leave the rain out for this evening, although we are going to be picking up a little bit of cloud cover by 8:30 tomorrow morning, maybe a spotty shower or two. And again, this model keeps saying, yep, there's going to be some sort of lingering boundary, maybe that sea breeze about 1:30. Still good enough for about a 20% chance of rain, and by 8 o'clock tomorrow evening, we're going to be seeing probably not a whole lot of rainfall. Again, our best chances for rain are going to be as we get closer to the weekend. In the meantime, going to be hot. Lower to mid-90s. If the cloud covers stick around, we're probably going to stay somewhere in the lower 90s. Your rain chances at 20% still going to be on the warm side and plenty humid. I'm going to go with clear to partly cloudy overnight tonight, warm and muggy. Temperatures in the mid-70s to right around 80. And your seven-day ExactCast is showing we're going to continue with this trend till about Friday, that trend being light rain or small rain chances and warm temperatures. It's Saturday and Sunday when I think we're going to get our best chance to get a cold front to push through here. Again, it's July. It's going to be hard. We'll put your rain chances over the weekend at 30 to 40%. Not going to be a washout as your afternoon temperatures don't warm up quite as much. They'll be staying in the lower 90s. I'm ExactWeather Meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on.